गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, इन अवर फर्स्ट लेसन टुडे वी विल गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द एक्सरसाइज. क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, एक्सप्लेन द फॉलोइंग कॉन्सेप्ट्स. फर्स्ट, द प्रोविजंस ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. द प्रोविजंस ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, द आंसर ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन इज हियर, प्रोविजंस इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. नाउ हियर द प्रोविजंस इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन आर अबाउट डिफरेंट थिंग्स. फॉर एन एग्जाम्पल, सिटीजनशिप, द राइट्स ऑफ सिटीजन्स, द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन सिटीजन्स एंड द स्टेट, subject of the laws to be made by the governments, elections, restrictions on the government, jurisdictions of the state, etc. These are the provision of the constitution. Now, second, constitution day. Constitution day means what? The constitution assembly enacted the constitution and adopted it on 26th November 1949. Therefore, 26th November is observed as a constitution day. Now, next question, discuss a constituent assembly was established. Constitution assembly was established. The answer of this question here. Now you see, India became independent on August 15, 1947. Before that, the British ruled over India. They had divided India into provinces like Bombay, Bengal and Madras for the convenience of the administration. The administration in this province was carried out by the people's representative. Similarly, the local princes were carrying out the administration in some areas. Now, next question. Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar is called the architect of the Indian Constitution. Because of this, see, now see, Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar handled the task of presenting the draft, answering the various questions raised on it, making changes in the draft as per the suggestion of the Constituent Assembly, and making every provision of the Constitution flawless. Due to this contribution towards the making of the Constitution, Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar is called as the architect of Indian Constitution. Now, next question, what is included in the administration of a country? What is included in the administration of the country? Now see, here, the governments in modern times have to take decisions related to different issues, right from space, research to public cleanliness. This is the governments of the administrations. Now see, next question, question number 3. Choose the right option. The constitution of this country is primarily unwritten. America, India, England and none of the above. The correct answer is England. The constitution of this country is primarily unwritten in England. Next, who was the president of the constitution assembly? Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, Dr. Rajendra Prasad, Durgabai Deshmukh and B.N. Rao. Among Dr. Rajendra Prasad, he was the president of constitution assembly. Next, who among these not a member of the Constituent Assembly? Mahatma Gandhi, Maulana Azad, Rajkumari, Amrit Kaur. So Mahatma Gandhi was not the member of Constituent Assembly. Next, who was the chairman of the drafting committee? Dr. Rajendra Prasad, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar and J.B. Kriplani. So Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar was the chairman of drafting committee. Now question number 4, answer the following questions. On first, on what subject does the government have to make laws? The subject of this here, the government has to make laws relating to several subjects, such as defending the boundaries, protecting the people from external aggression, eradication of poverty, creating employment, education and health services, encouragement to commerce and industries, protection of the weaker sections, making policies for the progress of women, children and the tribal people, etc. These are some subjects the government are making the laws. The next question, why do we celebrate 26th January as a Republic Day? Now see, the country began to govern according to the provision of the Constitution from 26th January 1950. The Indian Republic came into existence from this day, so therefore 26 January is celebrated as a Republic Day. Now the next question, What are the advantages of running a country as per the provision of the constitution? Now see, as per the provision, now see, these are some provisions. Government has to function within a set of rules. This reduces the possibility of the misuse of the power and authority they have been given. Now, a constitution includes the rights and freedoms of the citizens. Government cannot take away these rights. Therefore, people's rights and freedoms are safeguarded. Running a country as per the provision of the constitution is the same as establishing the rule of law. Then there is no scope for a misuse of power or high-handed administrations. Now, if a country is run as per the constitutions, the faith that the common people have in the governance increases. They then became keen on participating in the activities of the government. Democracy is strengthened due to the increased participation of the people. Then constitution presents some political ideals before the country. The nation is also bound to act in the direction. It creates an atmosphere conducive to attain world peace and security and preservation of human rights. Since the constitution also includes the list of citizen duties, it fixed to responsibility of the citizen as well. So there are six provisions are given. Among you have to write any two or three. So dear student, you have to copy down this question answer in your notebook.